everybody, it's your girl T. Graye. Welcome to the Love Below, and I'm sitting here with the used to be a cop, now I'm a comedian, Timmy Hall.
How are you? Nice to meet you. Nice to finally meet you.
I'm good. Welcome to the Love Below.
Welcome, man. Thank y'all for having me. Can't wait. Come on, let's do it.
So, my first question, which I want to know so bad. I've never worked on the end of law enforcement, but I can imagine that it's pretty interesting. Mm-hmm. Did you ever take any of those things in the bedroom? You carrying law enforcement cuffs? You carrying outfits? What? You pepper spray? What you doing?
Oh no, in the bedroom. We ain't had safe words. I just use mace. Sometimes I dish up, she likes it. I never did anything. You know what? A billy club. Yeah, my stick.
And you took it to
the bedroom? Yeah, I had my stick.
And what
you
giving out?
Spankings? Nah, I was baking. She just acted like she wasn't interested, so I hit her in the head. I never did. I never took anything in the bedroom like that. Nope, not handcuffs or nothing.
So, in changing your profession, did you change the way you behaved in the bedroom? Like, were you more lax now that everything is funny and not so tense than the job that you had?
To be honest with you, yeah, I did. I think I did. More relaxed now and everything more easy. So I'm not as fast now.
That's right, you take your time.
I take my time because I ain't got to worry about, handling the call and nothing. No, I really do. You know, when you retire, it's like your mindset changes. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to worry about time and stuff like that. You know, and I realize, it is all about y'all in the bedroom. I hate to say it.
It is also in it being all about the woman. Mm-hmm. Do you think there's no space for it to also be all about the man?
Depends on the woman. It depends on the woman. You got some women that are just selfish when it comes to sex. You know what I mean? But some women that don't mind pleasing the man. It just depends who you with.
And what do you think makes some women selfish? Like, what is it that they only want their nut? Or, what is it about these women that's selfish?
No, I can't say exactly, because I think a lot of women are different with different men. Some men can bring it out of them. You never heard of a man can bring this freak out of some women? Mm-hmm. Some men can bring the freak out of some women.
Amen to that.
I just haven't done it. I just haven't done it. I don't know where I went wrong.
It's okay with you guys. If you're following me, then you probably heard my radio interview that I did with Pillow Talk with Angela. And one of the things that I did mention was being a selfish lover. Mm-hmm. You cannot go into the bedroom with the gauze of the only person's pleasure you're seeking is yours. Mm-hmm. Now, if you're into some sort of fetish or whatnot, where that's the mission and that's what's understood between the two,
right,
that it is just, what you see, that's one thing. But if you're getting together, you're a couple, even one night stand, casual sex, whatever the case may be, if you're not just as into pleasing the person that you're with, somebody's being shortchanged.
Well, because I think people become complacent. You've been with somebody for a long time. Okay, I'm just going, as long as I'm giving it. I think a lot of women got that. As long as I'm giving it to him, he shouldn't complain.
But men think that too.
Men think that too
because as long as you're giving it to him, he shouldn't complain. Guess who's getting it?
I don't know.
Is he really pleased if that's the reception that the woman is getting?
I disagree. I think a lot of women out there, because I've been through it, I think a lot of women think our pleasure is your pleasure. Like, as long as we're pleasing you, we should be pleased. And I think that's where a lot of people go wrong.
But you know what? I'm going to tell you why some women might think that.
Why?
Because men say that. Men say to you, I just want to please you, baby. I just want to make sure you get yours, baby.
Why do we say that, though? Why do we say that? Be honest.
Tell me why.
We say that for one reason, because women's sex, when it comes to sex, it's not about physical women. It becomes, it's mental. So we have to say that. Before we even get to your body, most women, we have to get to your mind first. So we say that so you can loosen up, so you can enjoy yourself, so you can be our sexual.
Well, some men say that for years. I mean, you already getting the ass. You know what I mean? It's already, consistent, regular ass.
Okay, but see, that's what you're saying.
You come with that notion.
Right.
So do you not create the monster? Are you not creating the selfish, sexual monster?
I think women got a problem with quantity is better than quality.
Woo.
I think women say a lot of things. As long as I'm giving it to him every night, he should be happy. But if you give it to me once a week and it's the most freaky sex I've ever had, I can give a damn about once a night.
So, that's true. I'm not going to disagree with that. And I'm not disagreeing on that as far as men and women are concerned.
Yeah, okay.
We're not going to say
quality,
that all women
like
that. The girl T. Gray don't get down like that. The girl T. Gray likes to make sure my man is satisfied.
Okay.
But I get what you're saying. Mm-hmm. And when you do focus on quantity versus quality, mm-hmm. you're missing something.
You're missing a whole bunch.
You're missing something. The pleasure, the passion, the level of intimacy,
right.
all those things then change. Mm-hmm. But consider the demand, mm-hmm. okay?
But that's what you need to
just talk. Because a woman is giving it to a guy every day, mm-hmm. there's something in that guy that's showing that woman that, yes, I want it every day. So is his quality also diminished?
True.
You know what I mean? It's a mutual thing. It definitely cannot be one-sided, because just much as the demand for sex for a woman is mm-hmm. it's the same for a man.
But the problem is, a lot of women, when y'all want to hold sex as a weapon. And I'm going to tell you, when you hold sex as a weapon for a man, what you basically got is a gun with no bullets. It's useless, because you ain't the only gun out there. That's the problem. You can't hold sex as a weapon when it comes to a man. You got a gun with no bullets. It's useless. You think it's a weapon, but it ain't. It's a lot more women out here that give it to you, just like, you know, a man saying, just like women can get it, another man, just like that. But I'm just saying, though, holding sex as a weapon is an issue. You know what I'm saying? You can't do that. I know a lot of women that have been married a long time. So I ain't giving it to my husband. I'm like, sweetheart, don't worry about it. You ain't got to give him nothing. Because eventually he's going to find it somewhere else. Because if a man keep asking you for sex, first of all, your man keep asking you for sex, guess what? And he wants to give it to you every night. And y'all been together a long time. You should be happy and proud that man still find you that attractive after all those years. That's what you should be happy about.
Happy.
Point right.
So you feel like, tread lightly when mm-hmm. I ask, people lose attractiveness over time?
I think people lose attractiveness. Men lose attractiveness over women when it comes to sex, when a woman tells them no so often.
Okay.
Eventually, sex, if you in a relationship, you know, sex is more of a connection.
It is.
Having sex is a, when you take that away from a man, or take that away from a woman, just either way, you start losing the connection. Mm-hmm. And once you start losing that connection from sex, it's really hard to get that back.
You're right about that.
It's really hard to get
You're
it
right
back.
You're right about that. Yeah. I would totally agree.
Right.
So I speak very freely. You guys, you know that. And so I've had a relationship where that interest was totally gone. Totally mm-hmm. changed.
Who changed?
The dynamic of
who
the relationship.
Changed? You or him?
So I would say that it was mutual, because it was actions and then the consequences of those actions mm-hmm. that diminished the mm-hmm. sexual appetite.
Right.
So definitely wasn't one person or the other. I was the one who lost the interest.
Mm-hmm.
I did.
Right.
I did.
Once you lose interest in sex, the relationship is over. You gotta understand something. Men are shallow. Men and women are different. You are, all right, let me give you an example how women and women are different. We're so shallow. Y'all have a bad day at work. You come home from work pissed off, mad. We cannot ask y'all for sex because you just not there. Mentally, you're not there. Oh, God, I can't believe Sheila did. No, I hate this girl. You're like, baby, we're having sex tonight. You didn't hear me talk about Sheila? So, done. Man, have a bad day at work. You take a shower, you throw him down, you give oral sex or whatever, you have sex with him, guess what? You will never hear about what happened that day at work again.
That's true.
That's the issue. That's the issue. Men are simple creatures. I think women make us more difficult than we have to be.
We make you more difficult.
Yes, because y'all make it seem like we're more difficult. Women, before we even get to sex, y'all almost like an onion. We got to peel back all these layers before we even get to the ass. Right? You can't just go in. If you were a woman and you're a real woman, you gotta go through her emotional things. You gotta peel that back. You gotta agree with her. You gotta peel that back. You gotta get mentally with her. You gotta peel that back. By the time you get the ass, you don't even want her no more.
You're so busy, man.
You're
crying now because you feel about going to bed.
You peel her back on the legs and see the real her. Ain't no worse than seeing the real woman.
God, I know. Ladies, this is what we're doing to these
y'all
men.
Y'all killing us.
Killing them.
Y'all are killing us.
Oh my God, ladies. Get it together.
Yeah, I do. Oh my gosh. I don't know why someone's porn on my phone got a virus.
Oh my God.
I'm tired of y'all. My phone got an STD right now because y'all women. I can't do
you
it no more.
Your phone in your pocket.
I know. My phone's sick. My phone, I got a condom on my phone right now. My phone has a condom. I can't do it with y'all.
So, I don't disagree with your perspective, because that is your perspective. But I would have to say that it is just as difficult in dealing with you all. And even though for a man, yeah, you are logic, you are cut and dry, you are, you know, dick hard, you pussy wet, let's go. With women being, I guess, more emotional, okay? We speak more feeling, okay? If you don't understand the work it takes to get it, do you still appreciate it? That's one. And if you do meet a woman who's like, yeah, let me just get this dick and come on and see you later, do you have the same level of respect for her? Because society says when we do want it like that, when we are aggressive, when you don't have all that fluff to go to and we just want it and we just come on, let's get it, we're looked upon in a negative light.
You're right.
You know what I mean? We're looked at, we hoes or whatever.
See,
the case may be. But
I don't think women hoe if that's what she wants, because I feel like if that's what you want and it's cut and dry, I respect a woman like that. If that's what you want and that's what you want. You. Men do it all the time. I not think a woman's a whore if she wants sex with a man and she tells a man, this is all I want, whatever. I have no problem with that. Because to me, that's what you call a real woman. To me, that's a real woman. If a real woman can tell you what she wants, cut and dry, without all those bullcrap, bullshit, I love a woman like that. I love a woman like that. I do.
Guys say that.
I'm not saying.
You gotta get it. You'll be on some other shit.
What? Stalking y'all? What you mean? And your bushes with a helmet on?
Not necessarily stalking, but then can't handle what you've asked for. Then the roles then change.
I love a woman that can tell me what she wants. Now, see, I'm not as aggressive to a woman like that. I still have that. I'm my mama's boy, so I still have that little kind of respect for women, whatever. Mm-hmm. So when a woman tells me, if she's my woman, she's like, oh, I'm almost a dick tonight. I love it. Mm-hmm. Because it's cut and dry, she told me what she wants. When two people beat around the bush about it, it's the worst. What you doing tonight? Nothing. On TV. You touched it. I touched it. For about 2 hours, we done touched it. We ain't done that. Well, somebody say something. I love women that I love aggressive women. I love aggressive women. I do. Because I'm not that aggressive. Like I said, I'm a mama's boy, so I still have that. Women, I have so much respect for women. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You know, but I have been with somebody where I could be aggressive and tell them straight up, hey, look, this is what I want tonight. Can you come over here? And they was like, oh, sure, I'll be right over. I like that type of stuff. You know what I mean? Just tell me what you want. If I can, as long as I can tell you what I want. You know what I mean? That's the best relationship.
You know what you want.
Am I firm and I know what I want?
Yeah.
You know what? Until recently, I didn't, and now I do.
What changed?
Just my whole relationship at home, and I guess taking a new look at myself, mm-hmm. and realize what makes me happy, mm-hmm. and realize my happiness does not evolve around somebody else. Mm-hmm. That's what changed.
Ain't no problem with that,
Timmy.
Mm-hmm.
He said he's gonna
be happy, you guys.
Oh,
yeah,
he'll be happy regardless.
And I can't knock that at all.
Yeah, regardless.
Not at all. Mm-hmm. I'm so glad you came. I'm glad.
You got me sitting there ready to cry.
Oh, look. Peel back them layers, baby. Peel back them onion layers.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. Yeah, but y'all got don't have so many layers, women. God damn.
It's really not that many women, and I was just talking about this. You guys will see my interview with Don DC Curry, but I mentioned this, mm-hmm. that when we meet you, when we see you, we know whether or not we want you. We know whether or not you're gonna get it. We size that up immediately before the phone number.
True?
Hell yeah, before the phone.
I'm asking because I've heard so many women say that, and I'm like,
because it's the truth. First of all, if you walk the way with the phone number and it's the right number, your chances at that point of getting some ass are 100%.
Really?
Your chances are 100%. Now let me tell you what the problem is. You fuck it up along the way though, fellas. Okay, that's on your own. That's on your own. You know you go, if you already know.
Well, we say some stupid shit. We really do. We say some stupid shit. That's not, I ain't gonna lie. We say stupid shit. Yeah, we do stupid shit.
And then, you know,
a lot of men get this close to the ass and then say something stupid.
Y'all knock y'all shit out from 100 to 45% in the first date. Then you knock that shit down.
I told all men, the best thing to do if you want some ass, just listen. What? Really? Don't say shit else. If you take a woman on a date and all you do is agree, what? He's such a good listener. That, you know, she like it. She riding you to my girl. I think this is the one. All you gotta do is shut up. That's you won't get rolled that night.
That's funny.
That's the truth, though.
I'm not going to disagree.
That's the truth.
I'm not going to say that's how your girl get down. My standard is a little bit different.
No, but your standard is the same thing. If a man takes you out and can wow you and listen to you and listen to you.
Although I'm a talker, clearly, because I can't stop talking now.
If your man, you are easy. You just talk to you, listen to you, agree with you. All we do is act like I'm sitting there. It's not a yes man. It's a yes man that listens. And he understands your dreams and goals. He's like, what?
But the thing about it is, every nigga got that game. Every nigga runs that game.
Every nigga don't know how to run a game. Some men don't know how to do it.
Through who's full of shit and who's not full of shit. Your actions is what's gonna make the difference between you being full of shit and not full of shit. Your actions.
Well, I mean, it's the same thing with women. You know, you gotta find out women's intentions. You know what I'm saying? Me being a comedian on the road a lot of times, a lot of women gravitate with me, want to take pictures and this, that, and the third, but someone want to be with you because they think you want to be the star, or they think you this and that, or they want to be attached to your name. I don't like any woman that just wants to be attached to my name because she thinks I'm going to be something. You know, the woman I like really don't know who I am. She don't know I'm a comedian. She don't know I've been on TV, whatever. She ain't got nothing about me.
That curl pattern. She ain't got none of that.
That's right. I'm in there with a comb, my ass girl. I ain't worrying about her. But you know what I mean? But you know what I mean? I don't worry about this. You know what I'm saying? You gotta know, men gotta know the same thing. You know, oh, she run a game. She want money for rent. You know what I mean? It's a whole bunch of things you gotta learn about women. You know what I mean? Just like you gotta learn about men. But you just have to sift through the bullshit.
That comes more with the comedy game or in just being a man in general? Did you not have those same things go on when you were a police officer?
Yeah, the same thing. It was the same thing.
So it's just women.
It was the same thing. You know, it's the same thing. Yes, women.
It's more so now because
and I'm always traveling. I'm always different cities, and you know, a lot of women be like, I want to go. A lot of women I know, I want to go. Like I'm going to Houston this weekend. I want to go. You know, you got women that do that all the time. They just want to go. They just want to be attached to your name. You know what I'm saying? And you get to the hotel, she's like, I ain't saying who's going to do anything. You know?
Well, you wanted to go.
You wanted to go.
I'm devil's advocate like
shit. No. She touch your free. She already know. She
devil's advocate like shit.
Yeah.
I mean.
If she get on the plane, I'm telling her to have out the frame. That's how she act.
Okay, so with me. Mm-hmm. Working behind the scenes and in the realm of comedy.
Okay.
No, I'm not a comedian. You guys know my disclaimer. But I interview a shit ton of comedians, so I see a lot. Mm-hmm. And I would have to say that it would be crazy for somebody to think that most of these women don't have an angle. But the men, they got an angle too. You know what I'm saying? And if I'm going to be traveling with you, you need me to look a certain way, you need me to act a certain way, you need me to fuck you, whatever. Yeah. Am I wrong because I want you to take care of my shit? Is that wrong?
No. Is that wrong? I mean, no. But no. See, if you...
So if, when you're meeting these women, right. if now, I ain't mean to cut you off, but if you meet these women, and I don't know your situation, and say you sleep with the women, what have you, if that's what's going on, are you not leading them to the presumption that some aspect of your life will be sufficient as long as you're fucking?
No, because that's something that's established in the beginning. You got to establish that stuff. You know, that's
the ground rules.
Before you start the ground rules, you got to set the ground rules. I mean, if that's all it is, that's all it is. You gotta let me know what you want from me. Well, if I'm gonna fuck you, you say, well, you gonna take care of my bill. you're gonna do this. You know what I'm saying? You gotta let me know in advance. You know, that's the part of being mature and being adults. You know what I'm saying? You let everybody know in advance. You know, if you know my situation, I know your situation. Let's come to terms in between, and then we can figure it out from there. Problem is, you take a woman out of town or something like that, and you were thinking you're gonna get some ass, and you ain't established at the beginning. Something you should have said before you got on that plane. And you know, if we go here, you know, you're gonna take care of me, right? You know what I mean? It's either she gonna say yes or no. But you establish all that stuff before you even start. That's just protocol. I mean, for a grown man.
Hopefully the next person, I guess, who catches your eye will be somebody who does not know who Timmy Hall is. Somebody who can be understanding of these changes and you wanting to be happy.
Right.
And everything else. Hopefully, yeah, that's what you're trying.
I don't do the groupie thing. You know, people don't understand something about me. I'm the very most shyest person in the world. I hate a lot of attention. I've always hated it.
I believe that. I'm a very shy person.
Like, after I do a show, I love the audience reaction. I love their appreciation, but I'm so shy with taking pictures and all that stuff. I'm not that type of guy. Like, you're gonna lie, I'm like, anyway.
Yeah, I'm getting my picture today,
though. Yeah, I'm sure you but you know what I mean? I'm just that type of guy. So somebody that attracts my eye, somebody that's just in the background, don't even care who I am. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. That just, I don't know. That cater. You know the biggest thing is? Because I'm a nurturer. Mm-hmm. I want a woman to cater to me just like I cater to her.
Okay.
And that's hard to find. 50-50 is hard to find. I don't care what anybody's like. Something's really 50-50 is hard as hell.
Well, you know what? I don't think that everything can be 50-50. And I got married. Mm-hmm. I remember my uncle who been murdered longest forever, mm-hmm. went through some shit, came back from it, whatever. I remember him pulling me to the side and saying to me that in a marriage, one person has to love the other more.
Oh, yeah.
Or just in relationships in general, somebody has to love the other person more. And as long as you have that, it'll never truly be 50-50.
Right. Yeah.
Okay. Well, he's got to go to
stage. I'm getting the stage, y'all.
This has been great.
Thank you so much. I really enjoyed you.
We had more time. Thank you guys for checking out.
I got to hit the stage.
Thank you. Do your thing.
Thanks, baby. Appreciate you. Y'all remember, women. Stop all goddamn layers.
Now we said you was going to the stage.
Yeah, I'm damn layers.
Now we said it's your turn. Now.
That's why my arm's so big now. I'm pulling back all them damn layers.
That's what you're jerking off, you guys.
That's right.
You stupid.
Thank you for checking out. Love you guys.
Oh, that's really good.